All right, here we go.
Are you sure?
Good morning. Good morning, guys.
Good morning. Hey, how's it going?
Good.
If not, look us up online.
Well, now, hang on just a second, because I'd like this international crew to know that we know you personally.
Oh, absolutely.
You're not just somebody coming up selling us something.
That's right. Yeah.
So, tell me how we know each other, Scott.
I believe this lady has, like, styled everyone's hair that I know, my wife, my daughter, and that whole kit and caboodle.
How long?
For like 700 years.
All right.
I believe that's how far we go back.
And then let me ask you this. Do you remember the old days when everybody made fun of me because I refused to get online? Well,
let me just get into the core fundamental basics of what has happened. Basically, on the 1st of February, we lost internet to our studios of the CCN headquarters. And there was a lot of interfering with the internet providers and various aspects of the technical side, trying to establish the problem, which was established pretty early on. And we were able to confirm pretty much today that it was actually on Friday that we were given the inclination that it looked like we had had our line coming into our studio sabotaged. And today the tech who actually fixed it and looked at the whole thing has confirmed that it takes a great amount of brute force to do what was done to the line. It's absolutely deliberate. It's no accident. It's not like someone trod on the line and it broke. It's there's force there, there's deliberate, malicious, malintent to disconnect our line for the fiber optic services that we broadcast our network on. So it's not just attacks in terms of, you know, you had your website hacked, you had your YouTube hacked, or your Skype hacked, or whatever, or Facebook. This is actually now localized, all right? This is the fight has come to our doorstep, not even figuratively, literally.
I don't mean that. I'm talking to a drug monkey sucked into the mind virus dutifully spread by jealous, ill-meaning elements and agents of fear and suspicion to elevate themselves. And then when the people here in Holland making allegations, because trust me, he lives in Holland here with me, we've got a whole different set of politics going on here in the alternative media. There's been people recently after he left who made allegations about me. In fact, it was, you know, I told you earlier about that cult that gave us that lump of money. They were making allegations about me, about Biggie and I and all sorts. And they went to Johan to try and do a smear campaign against us. Johan came straight to us, asked us what the facts were, presented us to them, and they never came back to him. So guess what he does? He sticks them on his list of disinformationists. He's got a list, okay, that he's published. He just doesn't take bullshit. He's a very straight down the line kind of guy. He's the kind of guy who'll go, he's a researcher. He goes to the source. So if someone comes with allegations, he'll go to the source to check it out. That's what he did with us. He didn't publish bullshit online. He came to us and he checked it out.
Even his days.
Well, that's because I'm turning over a new leaf.
That's exactly right.
Me too.
Now, before we close out, do you have a message for the world that you'd like to send around the globe today?
Around the globe?
Yes.
Peace and love.
Make a difference.
Yeah.
You know, abide in the vine. You know, that's one of the greatest lessons of all.
Right. God is nature.
That's right.
I love a strong man that's in touch with his feminine side, guys.
Somebody just misspelled it.
I appreciate.
God is nature.
I appreciate your time today very much.
Yeah, thanks.
Always good to see you,
good
Scott.
Good to see you
Shy.
Too.
Take it easy.
Uh-oh.
Sorry, I didn't know if you were done there yet.
Oh, I'm like well done and burnt to a crisp.
Oh, you never just say I've thoroughly enjoyed it. You have such a way with words. And for anyone who has been listening to this, this actually has been a very good reminder for me too. Yeah, well, a well-worn warrior on this path. But nice to hear it eloquently spoken, just to remind us again what it is we are meant to be doing, and to remind ourselves, you know, to check ourselves. You know, we're not allowing the miscreant energies in, and that we're not falling into the distortions, that we're staying true to our purpose and staying firmly on the path. So, and that is definitely something I endeavor to do at all points. So thank you very much, Dee. That was so enlightening and so educational, and I love it that you put it across in a way that doesn't come across as, you know, too love and lighty, and you're not afraid of using a few fruity words. So it hits home real in a realistic, keeping it real kind of way.
That's awesome.
And I'm in Broadcast Journalism Academy.
Oh.
So.
Joe, how's that going?
I hope it's more exciting for her than it is for me. But I'm happy.
Good.
I'm really excited about
well,
promoting it.
People that think like this need to get together.
That's
need to
right.
talk, need to share the thoughts and ideas, and know what's going on out there.
Because it's simple and it's the right thing to do.
I'll open up what I always open up. Every Tuesday night, we have a focus group. We have a Zoom session. Using the Zoom application, it's a free app. Anybody who is inclined to come participate in our open forum is welcome there, until you're not. And my Facebook is attached to many of my interviews. You know, you can get me there. You know, it's Facebook.com/SHLEIMUTH, Shleimuth, which is like shalom, it means wholeness, like shanti, in Sanskrit, that's Hebrew. Shleimuth, SHLEIMUTH. You can find me there. You can email me at ZZENIX777@yahoo. I'm pretty available. And if you want to join this group, you know, we'll send you the code, pop in. There's generally a really active exchange and conversation going on that's, from our perspective, alchemically enhancing everybody involved by sharing, just by showing up and being present in an authentic manner. Come, you know, the invitation is out there. All are welcome until you're not.
You know, a little bit of a expertise and therefore a bit of an ego in some area. And then the difficult part as a leader is to balance and manage the egos, right? And that's one thing I learned to do when I was working in styling, in fashion styling in London. I was working with all these celebrities, and here I am as a stylist, happy to just, whoa, suck it all in. Be a shock absorber for all this crap that gets, like, directed at you. But anyway, I've managed that, and that's how I was able to run the Swiss Indo-African delegation for as long as I did. I was the coordinator and for the delegation there. And then I stepped away because, again, it was the same thing you're talking about. So it just managing with egos meant that I was constantly a shock absorber, which meant that I was constantly getting drained and hammered for having to balance out all the aberrant energies.
Literally. So they're hacking the fiber optic line into the CCN headquarters. That's pretty severe. That actually constitutes a criminal act. And we have already been in touch with authorities, and let's see how far we get. But we are taking this to the next level because we've actually got proof, the testimony of the people who actually service the line and who provide us with the fiber optic streaming, which we pay for. So they're in breach of contract, and they're under legal premise to obviously investigate it, because otherwise they stand a chance of being sued by us for not providing us with service for over a week. And well, of course, the report was very clear. This is deliberate. This most likely is sabotage. And we've got the report with us, and I would read it out, except that it's written in Dutch. So most people probably will not understand what it says, but it's very, very clear. We've had to write emails to all the other tenants in the building to obviously ensure that they were aware of what had happened, because obviously that's very concerning.
Well, that's okay.
At $2 a week.
It still gives you something to talk about. It's
$2. Yeah. Because a lot of people don't have real good things to talk about.
When you've got people sabotaging internet lines, and let's just say it's been very, very stressful for us. There's obviously a lot of questions flying around in our mind as to, you know, the motives and the connections of the people who may have been involved and what they're connected to. Are they Freemasons? All this kind of thing.
Okay, now hang on. Because I know, Mel, you're brilliant and use all these big words. But what it sounds like to me, as somebody just listening in, it sounds like somebody messed with the cable on the outside of your apartment building. Is that what you're saying? And then would it be the way that they can prove that is, of course, because there was damage done to their equipment on the outside of the apartment building. Now, as far as your business goes inside, humanitarian, non-for-profit, or whatever, I wonder if they're looking at your business inside of your home, and then at the same time, this report in Dutch, I mean, it'd be easy enough for you to translate it and read it to everybody, but me, just an observer that is dealing with you firsthand and know your tricks, I'm just trying to figure out if your lines got cut. So that's my vote.
Everybody knows mainstream media is puppeted.
Oh,
everybody knows alternative media can be full of shit and kind of like fear-provoking.
Oh, absolutely. Fear mongrels. Yeah.
Right, and so...
How do you make money? By selling fear.
And yeah, it's just been very difficult being offline. Of course, I'm sorry if I'm struggling and I'm sounding a bit monotone, but I'm in so much agony. I can't even describe. My whole back is seized up because I've not been able to do yoga. I take free yoga classes online. We've had no internet for a week. And with the additional stress, I would of course need the yoga classes at this time and have not had them. And so the breach in the line has actually caused me a severe amount.
Oh, so now you're going to claim pain and suffering on this now. Back when we were in Journalism Academy, I know you went to hot yoga at the studio somewhere, and even if you don't have your internet to do yoga, you can still do your stretches and everything. So I'm just putting this together, what you're doing.
Injury called discomfort, and
mental emotional and physical suffering.
That we were getting to people so much that they're right. Actually willing to go to the point of disconnecting our internet, and very deliberately so. So that's where we've been. I know I just wanted to say, first of all, thank you to Hoekstead and the McKenzies for keeping me entertained during the quiet. Of course, Biggie was still able.
Body, come to me, my body. Grow cold before they have tasted life. touch the woman's cheek. Shall not die yet to defend their lack of courage. I came to challenge a man, not a beardless boy. I give you a year's grace to grow your beard. 12 sweet, short months of life to do with as you will. But when the seasons have come full circle, we shall meet again. And you shall pay your debt to me.
He's still able to access the odd website at very slow speed off his mobile phone. Of course, we didn't have the fiber optic coming in there. But basic communication through Skype was possible, so we could inform our broadcasters of what was going on. Most of them, of course, have been aware that, you know, we're okay, we're working on things, but we haven't been too forthcoming as to what has been going on, because we must ourselves wanted to have all the facts before we disclose this information into the public domain.
You could have kept shows going on your Zoom room, I'm sure. You have that app on your cell phone, but I know you're just building drama and making your story bigger than the true one that I released, where you guys hacked my computer. So what you're trying to do is make your story bigger and better. And you've suffered so.
And we, of course, never want to be putting lies and allegations out there that we can't back up with proof. And it's the evidence is so strong, as I said, we will actually be taking stuff with the authorities, because this is deliberate malicious harm intended to, you know, this is causing loss and causing harm.
The problem, I know there's two sides to every story, and what I am now doing now is just giving Ve a chance to come forward, because he was like, he had the impression that we had a bad impression of him because of Randy, which is true. And I really hate myself for doing this, but I'm going to admit, because I made a mistake. You know, when I make a mistake, I'm very honest about it. I made a mistake. I dismissed him. I dismissed him because of Randy. It's actually big deal. We've got to stay away from Zoo, we've got to stay away from Freedom and Fly, because Randy doesn't like it. We can't bring him anywhere near the network. And of course we did that because we wanted to hold on to Randy, you see. But what I've realized is all these people that Randy falls out with, it's not the people's problem, it's Randy. Because that's what Roger said. Roger said, you know, Randy falls out with everybody and he blames everybody else. But at the end of the day, we've got to look at the pattern and go, hang on, the common denominator here, Randy, is you.
Okay.
You can't keep blaming everybody else for your issues. You've got to face the reality of the fact that you're causing conflict because of your ego or your insecurities or whatever. It's the same pattern. We see in everybody. There's nothing new under the sun. This is the same bullshit we see. We all have to work through our bullshit. Some of us have actually put the effort into working through it. Some people just wallow in the misery and patheticness and the ego for the rest of their lives, and they create a miserable life for themselves and they alienate everybody around them. And that is what Randy is doing. Okay? And I feel sorry for him.
What
is that? It is. I'm a compassionate person. Despite every ugly thing he's done to us, I actually feel sorry for him, because what I see is, I don't see Ada coming at us. What I see is a very hurt man who's flailing and directing that pain at others.
Suicide too.
Mm, yeah. I just see a very hurt man. That's what I see. And we never wanted to hurt him. It wasn't our intention to hurt him. And me standing up for someone who I thought was wrongfully attacked is hurting him. He really, really needs to do some self-work, because that's pure ego. Who can still be accessed by the archons, okay? And who has genuinely been able to make themselves pure in their spirit, stand in their true conviction, in their full presence, with their full faculties, under command of their full spiritual energetic being, not with some other demonic influences coming in. What it has shown, which is scary for me, is how many of these spiritual types are susceptible to demonic influence. That includes Randy, that includes Lisa and Danny and the whole unfuckers cult, that includes a whole bunch of people. I had an interesting conversation with Z, who, let me tell you what, is very clued up in metaphysics. That guy is really going to be the guy to interview when you do interview him, and it's about the metaphysical stuff. When he comes on to speak to me on Wednesday, what he wants to do is he wants to talk about who he is, where he came from, and his involvement with Randy and what happened there, because it's quite a story, and it's also quite a vicious story. What we want to do is just create a bit of a, I'm not out to bash Randy. All I want to do is give Z a chance to talk, because Z desperately wants to get it all on record.
Oh, yes.
What's next? There's often this sense like it's just happening, you know. It's just happening. It's not just happening. There is a architectural blueprint, if you will, that's embedded in our DNA, in our soul code genetics. But you know, this is a Nietzsche well developed this idea. He called internal recurrence. There is the potentiality of any individual by virtue of their code to be what they are. You are not automatically what you are.
It's intended to take us out. And yeah, we won't stand for that. We know how to deal with this sort of thing. We've got the legal training. We've got the backing of various people in terms of evidence and all sorts. I think those responsible for doing this must know that we are taking it all the way. And
that there should be a weighing of the severity of what you're doing by influencing others' minds.
Yes.
Because, I mean, look, I say a lot of things. And I am willing to, I've considered them, I've pored over them in this life for years before I ever spoke. I know what I'm doing, and I take responsibility for every bit of it. And that's some. Nothing is incidental or accidental. Yeah, it doesn't mean I might not misspeak here or there. You know, I'm not Jehovah. I'm just finding myself a central organizing node of our whole collective. It's very different. So anyway, that's where I stand. You know, please make this 2,000 individuals talking every day. And more. And bring this to the next level. Transparency and transformation. Transformation. That's what we need. We really need transformation to a totally new state where we are openly related. This is Cognosis, finding the others. I'm Z, and I am honored to have had the opportunity. May it be under better auspices next juncture with Mel Ve, who runs CCN with her devoted partner, Diggy. Thank you both. Thank you all. And wherever this goes, may it bring wholeness to all who listen.
Let me tell you something. I've lost Sharma. Lou is left over this.
What?
I've lost Roger. I've lost Hillary. And we've lost Randy. So it's four people.
Fuck! I didn't know you lost Sharma as well. And I heard
Sharma and Rebecca.
Yeah. Oh my God.
That's five people.
Fuck.
And Sharma says, there seems to be a collective opinion as a network. And I said, no, just no one in our network's stupid enough to go on a hate campaign against them. Okay? I'm not stopping anyone from doing anything. What I'm doing is being a beacon of the light and standing up and saying, this is what I'm doing. Okay? If anybody wants to know where we stand, because a lot of people do look to us for guidance. They come just go, holy fuck, this is going on. What do you do? I won't tell people what to do. I'll tell you what I'm doing. Okay, me, I believe is the honorable and integrity-filled thing to do. And if you want to do the honorable, integrity-filled thing to do, you're welcome to do as I do. I'm not saying to you, you have to. I'm so shocked. It's like the 18 months of friendship that Vicky had with him was just gone. And this is the thing that's most heartbreaking is that we actually, even we're very, it doesn't look like it, we're actually very simple souls. We love the people that we love. Okay, when we get close to people and people hurt us, It actually breaks us. Okay, it's fun. We're not the tough. People think, you know, we're just like an aggressive tough. We're actually deep down inside. We've got very big hearts, and all we want is to love everybody. And we did. We love Randy tremendously, and he really hurt us. He really fucking hurt us. I'm so saddened at the way he went, because he didn't even try. Our friendship meant nothing to him. He didn't even try to work it out. He just went to nuclear. No matter what we try to reach out to, we even asked Roger Landry to mediate. He said, please, can you mediate? Because, you know, if someone comes to ask me to mediate, I'd do it. When someone asks you to mediate, you can't say no. Roger said no. Because he was afraid. He was afraid of Randy. He's afraid.
I just saw a show with you and Roger just the other day.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a pre-record from another show that we've done.
Okay.
When he was doing a fundraiser for me, and it was his last show, and he asked us to play that as his last show. And I see Roger on good terms. I have no issue with Roger Landry as a person at all. Okay, it's a bullshit. None of his projects ever work, and he claims he's got this and that going. He's got bubble going, but you know, he's a typical door to door salesman. Okay,
and that it's not even a case of, you know, we're kind of guessing this is not what it may be. No, we know. We know. We've got all the evidence. And so now we are now going to file a charge with the police, see how that goes, with the city council. And, of course, the service provider that provides us with the internet, of course, their legal team is following through on this. They have assured us of it.
Is that because myself and my husband, Biggie, are two of the most amiable people you'll ever meet? We can adapt to almost any situation, and we have to, because we deal with a very vast, varied personalities, okay? Yeah. To some really hectic personalities are people like Jan Urban, Johan Olpa, and guess what? Two of the most extreme personalities, and we actually get along with them some of the best. You know why? Because there's no bullshit with them, okay? They're straight, they're direct. Johan sometimes says they're not. Could you not be a little more less brutal?
Hi guys, it's me, Suze Pratt, the holistic stylist. And I've been mysteriously locked out of my WordPress, so it looks like the jackasses are already stealing the website. So we'll just go ahead and look at it just to make sure you guys know it's me. And that I'm under a great deal of duress. And I've been ripped off for $3,000. So, we'll just let the bank know that and see what they do. You see, this is my logo with my copyright, Suze Pratt, 2016, my artwork. Sophia's Emporium, my show. Let's just see if the shows are still there.
I don't get pissed off when people leave. What I get pissed off is when people treat me dishonorably and they're not straight with me about things. You know, they're not honest with me about what's going on. And Lisa and Danny were very manipulative about the way they did things, okay? Because they didn't want to own up to the truth. They didn't want to have a conversation on this and admit the fact the reason they're leaving is because they did not want to help us raise the money to get the broadcast license be sorted for the following year, okay? Instead, they wanted to go off on their own and use...
Hang on a minute. Look at this mess you've made here. You better fucking clean this out before you ascend, buddy.
Right.
And So things are going to lighten up. I'm so excited about that Elul himself, Yahweh, who's created this havoc here for the last, you know, several thousand years, right, is actually cleaning this shit up now. And this show this morning, John told me, was part of Enlil's own disclosure. What it was basically Enlil passing on the message about his soul progress and what the planet's in for.
And it's going to be one way or another. Whoever is responsible for this is going to be held accountable. But I'm not even that bothered about, you know, any form of, you know, I'm angry, I've got revenge. I'm just happy to be reconnected and also to know what it is. But it's also rather unsettling. There's a real feeling of being very unsettled about this because it's clear now that they know where the HQ of our broadcast studios are, and they're deliberately trying to cause damage to a humanitarian project which supports a number of amazing people in their pursuit, in various social justice pursuits.
So how much promotion you do is up to you. We simply don't have the resources or the manpower to do the amount of promotion we'd like to do for every single broadcast. And we can't treat broadcasters differently. We've got to give you all the same. So we rely on you guys to make sure that you promote your material. It's not up to us to promote it. It's up to us to give you a good service in terms of broadcasting.
Yes.
That is what we do. We provide you service of broadcasting. We process your archives. We get them posted out there, etc. Yeah, I never managed his online social media stuff, so he never grew. What do you say? His fan base didn't grow. But he's been doing this for years. He's been for at least 20 years doing this stuff. His fan base is pretty limited because it's largely the Dutch market. It's got a very limited international fan base. Most of his markets is Dutch, which is, of course, a different language altogether. So it's pretty stagnant in terms of where he can go to next. You know, I said he needs to publish his next book in English and maybe even have a better market reach. So that was his...
And of course, it's just devastating that there are people out there who would go to this level of maliciousness. And I shouldn't be surprised. I mean, people wage wars every day for finances. It's just when we're genuinely here trying to create a better world, working on projects across the world, doing all these things that we do, for people to get that malicious that they would actually sabotage our internet, it just beckons, you know, beggars belief. We're back, so they didn't succeed for longer than a week, which shows that they can't keep us down for terribly long, whoever it may be. And, what it does show us as well is that we potentially would have to relocate base at some stage. But, you know, it doesn't matter where we relocate to. There's so many different ways in which, with technology nowadays, you can find people and disable them. Even through electromagnetic pulse, they could disable our entire system. So it's not even worthwhile doing. It's not even worthwhile. It's not even worthwhile turning on our heels and running. It's actually at this stage, knowing what we know and having the connections and contacts and abilities that we have, it's probably worth our while just to stand here and fight back and stand our ground, because I
right.
refuse to be bullied by anybody.
Right, be accountable.
To let anybody make me feel like I've got to run away.
Let people know your real name,
so
where you live, and what
we're
you're doing.
Stand our ground, and we've got all the facts. We've collected all the details and the evidence for some time now, because we've been more than aware of something very fishy going on in relation to this matter.
Here we go. Now here's the connect. Okay, so basically, somebody damages cable property, they sever the line with the fiber optics and the phone, and now she's going to connect that to all the back stuff that happened and start doing the little witch hunt thing where she calls people out and actually slanders and gives misinformation. Okay.
Too. Yeah. He wrote that expose.
John Funnyman piece.
Yeah.
Yeah, he told me he's John Funnyman, which I thought was really good.
I said, you're a fucking genius. He said, I am a fucking genius.
Well, I think he's a very interesting character. I wanted to see what kind of dude, you know, like I said, we're going to speak to him. Hear a story and then just balance out the playing field a bit, you know.
Luca, I've been over there waving at you.
I did not see you at all.
You didn't even know it was me.
My sister.
I try and watch everything that I can to keep in touch with, you know, the family too, you know.
I try as well. I'll be honest with you, I don't get to see everything just simply because we don't have the time. But it's a simpler case of the later shows, I don't make it. Monday, I do the No Holding Back every second week, but also your show comes immediately afterwards, 8 o'clock. I always miss it if I'm in the academy because I need to get to sleep, and then I'll watch it the next day when we do the uploads. So yours is one that I have been watching since I started doing Journalism Academy the next day. Since I normally watch your show live, the Saturday evening is our Saturday evening and ice cream treat. Ben and Jerry's and Swiss. Like, the three of them. Ben, Jerry's and Swiss. But she actually made an ice cream called that. Ben, Jerry's and Swiss.
I find you guys to be really entertaining. I know you all probably think you've got this serious, critical, sensual voice, but I just get a kick out of you guys because you're funny to listen to and watch. And and it's been an interesting time because there's been some very funny comments posted, particularly in relation to us and what people think has happened to us. People think we've died, or it's the death of a CC and all our former work broadcast. No. We unfortunately were very seriously demobilized as a network because we had our external line hacked to our studio, very deliberately so, or deliberately sabotaged, I should say. So, it's been interesting as well to see a couple of people. Oh, I wish I was a fly on the wall in the CCN studio.
It's a maxi pad for humidity.
Yeah, I got one too, right inside.
Girls are too scared to wear them in public.
Joe's always got jokes. Remember when they always used to call you Joe Fiction?
Don't you need to tell someone before you start taping them, though?
Well, you're
these conversations may not be construed like...
Considering you're the other half of me and we know each other's thoughts, what the fuck, right?
All right.
I can turn the camera on you whenever. I just wanted to show everybody your outfit and your walking stick, because damn.
But you didn't walk, you drove.
Yes, I walked from the Jeep here. See, this here is, this here has a piece of copper from the tip through wove through all the natural cracks of the stick all the way to the top. So I'm touching the ground. Barefoot on the ground is good. Grounded is good.
Oh, I love that man so much. See, you guys think I talk a lot. Just wait until Joe starts. So, oh my God, I got somebody waving.
No, you don't. Nothing happening here. Just sitting around waiting for the bloody internet to be switched on and all the drama to go away so that we can carry on doing what we do. Because guess what, guys? You just can't get rid of me. I'm not going anywhere. I would also like to make a few comments with regards to things that have kind of been going on behind the scenes just prior to us going off air for a bit as well. And that is, I'm not going to feed the Hoaxsteads or the Devil's need for Angie hate fodder. I honestly, I've gotten over the whole Angela Power Disney, and there were a couple of people on the Hoaxstead blog begging me to give them more, but
yeah, you wrote a naughty enough letter to her. I've had enough.
I don't think it's dignified to go on flogging a devil.
Yeah.
I'm with you, and I'm staying.
Yeah.
And I believe in.
Hey, community. We, you know, there's a part of our community that runs, but there's a part of our community that stays, and I'd rather be with the part of the community that stays.
We're the fucking strong ones, my friend.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank
and
you.
I didn't mean to ask you too serious of a question. I apologize.
It's all good.
I'm just learning to be a journalist.
Sure.
And so I mess up.
Hey, I know all about, you know, public communication. So you gotta ask the triplet. Is it like the questions in the series, like a triplet? Like you gotta ask like an initial question to break the ice. Then you ask a question to kind of in the middle. Then you ask a question that's over the top. I think that's all part of your. Is it not?
Well, see, I've been a hairdresser my whole life, and
sure.
So I ran a small business for 30 years. I don't follow rules very well, and I like to create my own circumstance.
Sure.
So it kind of sucks because a lot of people think hairdressers are like ding-dongs and goofballs, and a lot of people think journalists are too. So it kind of hard.
I have met some journalists because I do live in Ferguson.
Gotcha.
So I've been personally engaged with journalists, and I'd have to agree with you on that one, that I certainly believe that, and this is on camera, that some journalists are certainly ding-dongs.
If we put an energy out, and if you put a warrior energy out, then people will leave you be.
Yeah, just respect people. You know?
Right.
I respect people, so I expect people to respect me.
Right.
If they don't respect me, then we have a problem.
Right.
But
it's not
that I disrespect people.
My dad
was... someone tries to disrespect me.
My dad was a cop, so I saw all sides of it.
Yeah.
And it's about the respect for anyone.
Yeah, respect for yourself.
That's right. God, you did good tonight, man.
Thank you.
Bless your...
Hey,
I'd give you a five if I had a fucking arm, man.
All right, have a good night.
Take care.